I was like, this lady is just kind of out of her mind. I'm literally not even talking to her. She kept repeating, take it easy. I looked at her face and I said to her, take it easy on the Botox and the fillers. I didn't know what to do with that information and didn't process it, but she did walk away eventually.
Here I had an argument with a lady. Cutting in line, more later.
Ryan, get candy.
She like refused it. I'll do the candy taking. Thank you.
No.
Oh my god. This guy is scary.
You go first.
Don't ask that guy for candy.
Go ask for candy, go!
Go, with my kid. That's brave, Jordan. Still went for the kid.
That was brave.
That doesn't look very scary.
Ooh, what? What?
He.
What is he?
I don't know.
I don't know, he's kind of big.
He doesn't look scary, though.
Whoa. He's a big guy.
Isn't that scary? Isn't that scary? Well, coach, I just need to rip the chicken off of your wristband.
Oh, it's a start.
Trick or treat. No tricks here, just treats. But there might be some tricks with that curtain. Here you go. Your favorite.
Babe.
No?
That guy looks scary.
Yeah, he did look scary.
This is a cool costume. What? That's
class. Here you go. Jordan. You got a bird?
Yeah.
What
and
happened
I got
today?
Fish. I got a fish.
What happened today?
I ended up with another child to take care of.
Get to your bird binder.
We got fish and we got a bird.
Yeah. How does that work? The fish were supposed to replace the bird.
Mm-hmm.
But now we ended up with the fish and the bird.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it says the number. It says
Ow, why it keeps pushing me?
You know what?
This one's happening.
March 20, 2023 is your bird's birthday.
I got the bird!
Ooh. Aww, I'm happy for you, baby.
Thank you. How am I going to get in and
out? Hey!
Two pieces were four.
We also got some fish today.
And a bird.
I want to take the fish right now.
Fishy.
And what did you say? Did you have fun at jiu-jitsu? Was so cute. Raya was Elsa.
Okay, super busy day today, but I just wanted to leave you with a piece of peace. And actually, I was contemplating whether I should share this or not. And you know what? At the end of the day, I want to be authentic and real with you guys and give you real stories and experiences that we can use as learning examples. At the trick-or-treating hiking trail thing that we went on, there were two lines. So there was the regular line and then the RIP line, right? So we went on the RIP/VIP line. It was basically like a fast pass line. And we were at the front and we were waiting a very, 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 very long time because there were people ahead of us that were just, whatever, taking a long time. Doesn't matter. We're online. Then all of a sudden, my husband and I noticed that a whole other family just appeared out of nowhere on the right side of us at the very front of the line. The lady behind me tapped me and said, well, is there any way that I can just stand ahead of you because this line isn't moving ahead fast enough? And I said, well, we're online, but you know, my husband's already gonna be next. You can go in front of me, that's fine, whatever. Just waiting. And I never like to assume, I never like to make assumptions on what's going on because, you know, maybe I missed something, maybe they were already there. But then I realized the lady that was tapping me behind me was related to the person that was on the side, what I had assumed, cutting in line, and that was for sure what they were doing. And so I didn't say anything until we got to the very front and the girl checked us in. I said, you know, you do have to look up once in a while because there are people that are coming over to the side here and cutting everybody in line. You just got to look up once in a while and see who's next. And then the lady who cut was about to leave and be on her way, turned around, got in my face, and she further continued to push up on me, like in my face. And I said what I said, and I'm talking to the girl right here. I was holding Raya in my arms. At that point, Ray took note. Everybody's looking at us. At that point, Ray came around me, came in between us, and said, back off, back away, back away. He calmly said, back away, back away. His main concern is I'm holding a baby. And she's yelling, take it easy, take it easy, take it easy. And which to that point, I was like, this lady is just kind of out of her mind. I'm literally not even talking to her. She kept repeating, take it easy, looked at her face. And I said to her, take it easy on the Botox and the fillers. I didn't know what to do with that information and didn't process it. But she did walk away eventually because my husband was also like in between us, like, you need to step back and take it. You need to take it easy. And the point of this is stick up for yourself, speak up, stand up for yourself. Don't be stepped on. And being a peaceful person doesn't just mean that you're just being taken advantage of. And for me, I thought my communication with the front girl was proper and was what was needed. So that's what happened. But you know, after that situation, we did bump into them in the on the way to the trail, and my whole vibe was after we got checked in, I just breathed in, breathed out, exhaled it all out. And by the time we saw them again, I was like, not even mad at you, girl. Not even mad at you. Just keep it moving. Keep it moving. Don't hold grudges. Personally, did not want to take that energy with me into the trail because I was there for my kids and I wanted them to have a really good time. It was not about me. It was about them. That's this week's piece of peace. Being a peaceful person does not mean that you are taken advantage of. Speak up when needed. Let me know in the comments if this resonated with you and what you would have done. Would you have done something different? Let me know in the comments.